This asana is called Ustarasana. It helps to reduce fat on thighs, stretches and strengthens our shoulders and back, expands the abdominal region, improves digestion and alimentation. It is also beneficial for improving respiration. This asana is called Bhujangasana. Bhujangasana strengthens the spine, stretches chest, lungs, shoulders, and abdomen. Stimulates organs in the abdomen like kidney. Improves circulation of blood and oxygen, especially throughout the spine and pelvic regions. This asana is called Vrikshasana. Vrikshasana helps to strengthen the legs and opens the hips. It improves our neuromuscular coordination. It helps with balance and endurance. It also improves alertness and concentration. This asana is called Gomukhasana. It improves our body posture, increases blood flow, and ensures the body gets more blood and nutrition. Cures sciatica infection, stimulates the kidney, and relieves stress and anxiety. This asana is called Matsyasana. The asana stimulates the pituitary glands and increases the blood supply into the head. It helps in dealing with respiratory problems and is helpful with asthma and bronchitis. It aids the immune system and improves the blood circulation in the body. This asana is called Bakasana. It strengthens our arms so they can hold our body weight. It strengthens our core to help hold us up. It also strengthens shoulder stabilizers and prepare us for other arm balance. This asana is called Sirsasana. It calms the brain and helps relieve stress and mild depression. Stimulates the pituitary and pineal glands and also strengthens the lung, toes and abdominal organs. This asana is called Balasana. It helps to reduce tension in the back, shoulders and chest. Normalizes circulation throughout the body. It stretches muscles, tendons, ligaments in the knee. Calms the mind and body. And also encourages strong and steady breathing. This asana is called Dhanurasana. The asana stretches the entire front of the body, ankles, thighs, abdomen, and chest. Strengthen the back muscles and also improve posture, stimulates the organ of the abdomen and neck. This asana is called Mayurasana. Mayurasana provides good stretch to the arms and back. The asana strengthens the forearms, elbows, legs, back torso, and wrist joints. It also helps in improving the posture. This asana is called Chakrasana. Chakrasana expands the chest and the lungs get more oxygen. This makes the pose especially beneficial for the asthma patients. It reduces stress and tension in the body. This asana also helps to strengthen the back and increases the elasticity of the spine. This asana is called Nataraj asana. Practicing this asana gives strength to our chest, ankles, hips, and legs. This asana increases our metabolism and helps in weight loss. Our posture is improved and balance is increased. This asana is called Vajrasana. This asana helps to keep the mind calm and stable, curing digestive acidity and gas formation. It helps to relieve knee pain, strengthening thigh muscles, and also helps in treatment of urinary problems.